UK nurses' salary. There's nobody that can tell you the exact amount you as a UK nurse is going to receive, because there are so many reasons why your salary will be different from the other person. Myself and my colleagues who are in the same workplace, we don't work the same hours. Even if we work the same hours, there are different deductions and different reasons why your salary will not be the same with your colleagues. On nobody's going to be able to tell you you're going to end this particular amount in the month. Even you yourself, you may not know, because your circumstances may change, the hours you work may change, your pay rate differs from where you stay, where you work, which part of the UK you are. In Northern Ireland, the salary is different from when you're in Scotland, when you're in England, when you're in the middle of London, and that is how it works. So there are different factors that will affect what you earn per month, and it is not the same for everybody. There's nobody that can tell you categorically this is what you're going to earn. Somebody had asked, I was off 1,500 per month. Should I take it? Is it a good offer? I will not be able to tell you it's a good offer or not, because you don't know, depending on what area of the United Kingdom you're staying. How was it calculated? Is it per hour? What is best going to pay you per hour? The most important thing about salary is what you're going to be paid per hour. Do not be deceived by your contract. You may get a contract that says you're going to be paid 40,000, you're going to be paid 30,000. It looks really big, especially if you don't know what it entails, but the hour matters. You can be taking 30,000 and you're working 44 or 48 hours a month. And someone is working just 36 hours and is earning the same 30,000. So what matters is what you're paid per month is not how much it is a year or what is in your contract. You have to be very careful, because the employer will just tell you you're going to get 40,000. You feel, oh yes, I'm going to get 40,000, but you're not going to check. You should check what hours you're working, how much is paid per hour. That is the most important thing. Please do not forget. It is very, very important. What you get in Northern Ireland, in Scotland, Wales, England, Central London differs a lot from either care home or NHS. If you don't know what the difference between NHS and a care home is, just follow this link and you will get all the information you need to know about the differences between the care home and the NHS. If you're in the NHS, you get lesser pay. If you're going for the care home, you're going to get more pay. Before you become a registered nurse, once you get into the United Kingdom, you're still below band 5. Band 5 is the level for a registered nurse. Once you have your pin, then you start from band 5. But before the band 5, you can be between band 3 and band 4, depending on your employer. Before you're registered in the care home, you can get between £9 to £12 per hour, depending on where you sum up to about 20 to 26,000 per year, divided by 12. Then you'll be able to know what you're going to get per month. While in the NHS, before you're registered as a nurse, you can get between £9 to £11 per hour, times it by the number of hours you're going to work, multiply it by 12, and that's what you're going to get per year. What specialty you've got, if you're like a maternity nurse specialty, like you're a mental health nurse, they have different pay rates. You work, do you work with NHS or private care home? Are you working with agency? Are you a bank staff? It also affects how much you're going to get per month. How many hours do you work per week? Some people work just 32 hours, 33 hours, 36 hours. You can choose whatever hours you want to work, and it's going to greatly affect your salary. Either it's going to be higher or lower. Some employer will pay you for your break. Some will not pay you for your break. Some places you can be working 48 hours in a week, but you're going to be paid for 44 hours, because 1 hour is not going to be paid, because you're going for 1 hour break. Break will be split between 15 minutes, 13 minutes, and whatever works for where you work. But those things also are going to affect how much you're going to get at the end of the month. Deduction also can affect how much you're going to earn, because after you've gotten your pay, you're going to pay national insurance, you're going to pay tax, you're going to pay pension. If you're a sponsor to come to the country by your employer will start to deduct their money, and those are the factors that will also make your salary to be reduced. If you're working bank or agency, I'm going to put them together. Agency nurses are those ones who come to work when there is shortage of staff. They are agents who have nurses that works for them. You can have your regular job, you can have your basic full-time job, whether NHS, care home, wherever it is you're working, you're a nurse. Have nurses that works for them. Whenever care homes or hospitals, wherever need nurses, they call the agent. Agent will send you to, it can be anywhere around where you stay. You're going to indicate the times you're going to be free. Your off days, you tell them where you can take the jobs, and they will contact you to ask you if you can take the job, then you drive or you go there to take the job. Agency work is, you can be posted to anywhere. It can be odd places, difficult places to get to, and you're not used to the people you're going to work with, but if you love the job, the pay is higher. It's very good. So agency nurses, once you're registered, you have to work for a few months before you're allowed to become an agency nurse. In Scotland, it's about 6 months. Agency nurses get between £16 to £35 per hour. The factors that determines how much you're going to get can be the band level that you are from 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Where you live, if you're living in London, you're going to be paid higher. Any salary from 12,500 below, you're not going to pay tax on that amount. For instance, your salary is 20,000 per year. 20,000 minus 12,500. Whatever is remaining, you're going to pay tax on that remaining amount. You're not going to pay tax on the 12,500. So when you get your annual salary, you're going to deduct 12,500. Then the remaining one, you minus the tax. And the tax deduction rate is 0% from salary between 12,500 and lower. 12,501 to 50,000 salary a year, you're going to pay 20% tax on that. 40% deduction on salary between 50,001 to 150,000 pound per year. 45% tax deduction for salary above 150,000. So salary from 150,001 will begin to deduct 45% of your income. So that's how the tax is being deducted. While you still have to pay the national insurance fee, insurance is 12% of your income. It also varies on where you stay. So you're likely going to be deducted 20%. So 20% plus the national insurance is 12%. So it's going to be 20 plus 12. That's 31%. So when you get your salary per year, minus 12,500, you're not going to pay on that. Then whatever is remaining, minus 31%, that is what is going to be deducted from your salary. So you may hear that someone will tell you, is any 1,500, 2,000 pounds, and you're like, it's a lot of money. No, they're going to be deducted some amount also. But those tax and the other deductions are before your salary. So whatever you get at the end is what you're taking home. The salary, the tax has been deducted before your salary balance. What cope with the tax deduction and the tension and the anger is that when you just know that that is not part of your salary. So don't even look at what you're being deducted. Make sure you have the correct tax number. Employers should make sure once your account has been opened, you're going to be on payroll. Your first salary, or even before your first salary, make sure you contact your, if you're not on the correct tax, once you get your salary, you're going to get emergency tax deduction. Some people are the first few months, you're on emergency deduction because they don't know your tax number. So they will just deduct something. Sometimes you can lose as much as 1,000, but they're going to pay you the money back. But it's going to be like, you're just coming, you don't want your money to be deducted. Of course, you need money and you don't want to go into like having to wait for your money to be returned over the next 2 months. So immediately you get your job, please, and you start your work, make sure you follow up with the person who is in charge of your pay to make sure you're placed on the correct tax code. The first number, the first alphabet should be correct because it's very important. So you're not going to be placed on emergency tax deduction. Please, please, please read your contract very well. Don't just see big money and sign. Make sure you understand how many hours you're working. And one tip I'm going to say, things I wish I had known, you can be sent like, oh, you're going to be getting 40,000 per annum. You're excited. But you've been placed on 48 hours work. That means you're working 4 days, 12 hours long shifts every week. I usually advise people that are just coming, it is better you take like 36, I don't know, just take 3 days, few days in the, as if it's acceptable, take few days in the week so that the remaining days, like you have like 4 days off, you can go for either you go for bank, you go for agency, you take extra, because during when you're on extra, if you're taking extra shift, even if it's the same workplace, you're going to be paid higher. For instance, on care home, that when you're on extra shift, you're paid 20% of your basic salary, or you're paid, that's 20% of your basic salary extra, or you're paying 50% of your basic salary extra. You see the difference? The same job, the same workplace, but different pay. Some people can be paid maybe £16 per hour on a regular basis, but when you're on extra, you're paid £20 per hour. Have you seen the difference? So Don't take too many hours when you're coming. Don't take too many days, like 4 days, 5 days, and then when you're off, you're stranded, you can't do anything. You're not useful for yourself, you're not useful for your family. You cannot go for extra shift. You can UK needs a lot of nurses, so you can't be stranded in one place. Take few, as much as possible, take few days, use your off days for either bank, agency, extra shift, or something else. Okay? But if you're okay with the 4 days work, it's fine. So please like my videos, subscribe. Even if you're not going to like it, just please subscribe. Subscription is very important. The red button below, please try to press the button, be subscribed. So you need to keep sharing in groups to make sure it gets to you. You just get automatic notification that my video has been posted. Thank you so much. Thank you for watching.